In this week's AMT Fresh Produce Outlook on the Market, we look into price movements on the fresh produce markets as usual, and Provaldo Kriegel will share his thoughts on what the Moody's downgrade to junk status will mean for the South African economy and for me and you going forward. All in this week's video, so make sure not to miss this episode. Hi, I'm Johnny and welcome to this week's AMT Fresh Produce Outlook on the Markets, made possible by Standard Bank. These videos are aimed at keeping you up to date with the latest trends on the fresh produce markets of South Africa, so make sure to like and share this video. But let's go and see what happened to vegetable prices the past week. We saw potato prices increasing by 9% to R36.43 per 10 kilogram bag, while tomato prices increased by 16% to R6.13 per kilogram. Carrot prices traded 19% higher on R5.08 per kilogram, while onion prices increased by 18% to R4.88 per kilogram last week. We're experiencing very high demand for especially vegetables on the markets currently, and we're therefore expecting that most vegetable prices will remain in an upward trend for the coming week at least, especially for your higher quality produce that is in high demand from your retailers. The fact that some hawker trade is limited will mean that lower quality products and the prices for lower quality products will remain stable or even come under pressure. Other vegetable prices traded as follows last week. Cabbages on R2.83 per kilogram, garlic on a very high R78.64 per kilogram, spinach on R3.64, sweet potatoes on R4.21, peppers on R9.14 and chilies on R7.11 per kilogram. When we look into the fruit industry, we saw a whole nother picture, with banana prices decreasing by 13% to R10.11 per kilogram last week. The apple and especially the pear market is currently under severe pressure due to high volumes currently in the market, and especially the pears that hasn't got such a long shelf life when compared to apples. We've seen that the latest apple price traded on R7.75, while pears traded on R5.98 per kilogram last week. Orange prices got some well-deserved support the past week. This was mostly due to high demand and consumers demanding more health-related products, and the price increasing by 13% week on week to R4.73, although volumes increased by 29% over the same period. Avo prices remain under pressure, and which can mostly be ascribed to the fact that we are receiving very high volumes on the market, but we have also seen that demand is currently limited also for avos on the market, which is putting more pressure on the avo price, which decreased by 2% week on week to R10.18 per kilogram. Grape prices increased by 16% to R16.63 per kilogram, while the latest pineapple price traded on R12.13 and peaches on R16.90 per kilogram. High demand for lemons, as was mentioned last week, resulted in the price to increase by 28% week on week to R8.42 per kilogram. As most of you might know, South Africa were recently downgraded to junk status by Moody's, which will have a severe impact on the South African economy, and me and you are there. Provaldo Kriegel will now share some thoughts on what this will mean for me and you going forward.
On Friday, the credit rating agency Moody's has cut South Africa's sovereign credit rating to sub-investment grade. I briefly want to explain why it happened and then what it means. The reasons that Moody's give for this downgrade to junk status is that South Africa's fiscal position has deteriorated. The budget deficit and the public debt has worsened, and coupled with structurally weak economic growth, it seems unlikely that it will improve in the short run. Putting aside the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, Moody's also highlighted the familiar constraints to economic growth in South Africa. That is an unreliable electricity supply, weak business confidence and investment, and long-standing structural constraints in the labor market. They recognize that there are policy initiatives that try to improve competition and to create jobs, but say that it does not constitute a step change for the South African economy. It doesn't go far enough. They also say that the planned land reform process is creating uncertainty and that the strategy to stabilize Eskom and the electricity supply has been slow to emerge and has not yet shown to be working. When we add to this the deteriorating global economic outlook caused by the coronavirus, South Africa is entering a period of lower economic growth globally while already in a vulnerable position. So what does this mean? In the short run, it's going to be difficult to untangle the effects of the credit rating agency's decision to downgrade and that of the coronavirus pandemic. If you consider only the downgrade for a moment, the impact is firstly that South Africa's government bonds will not be included in the FTSE World Government Bond Index. That means that around $5 billion or 88 billion rand is going to be pulled out of the economy by foreign investors who have to sell the South African government bonds in their portfolios. This will surely cause the rand to depreciate. In future, government will have to borrow at much higher interest rates, and this will translate into higher rates for households and other investors in the economy. It could lead to a downward spiral of increasing prices, low investment, job losses, and in the end, a debt trap for government. Adding to this, the impact of the COVID-19, there's already been significant sell-offs of equities and bonds and the depreciation of the currencies of emerging markets when investors turn to safe havens in these times of uncertainty. The sovereign downgrade will further add to the pressure in the financial markets and weaken the rand. There are some market participants who say that the impact of the downgrade has already been priced into the market, but it is difficult to say to what extent this has happened. It is likely to get worse before it gets better.